Hello, what is up guys? I am Gordon. After watching a video from Doug DeMuro about the in-depth car review of the Mitsubishi Mirage, I kind of think that the cheapest car in Malaysia, the Perodua Axia, isn't that bad of a car. That is why I borrowed that car from my girlfriend to bring you guys a pretty much an overall review of the Perodua Axia, the cheapest car in Malaysia. If you're in your early 20s and you are broke AF and you need a car, basically any cars will be expensive due to the excise duty. But no worries, there is two national brands that you can choose from, which is kind of cheap, which is the Proton and the Perodua. Given that Perodua is a little bit much more budget friendly, so we decided to go with the Perodua Axia, which is by far the cheapest new car in Malaysia that you can buy. In terms of the exterior, the Perodua Axia isn't that bad. Actually, it kind of looks, you know, really sporty compared to the Mitsubishi Mirage that's being reviewed by Doug DeMuro. And yes, we are talking about the blackout headlamps with some chrome accenting inside, but there's no LED though, which is kind of sad. And there's like chrome accent over here, you know, very nice chrome accent near the spotlight area. In Malaysia, we call it the spotlight, but yeah, maybe in other country, we call it the fog light.
Actually, the rear lights looks very unique. In fact, it looks kind of modern though. It doesn't look like a Malaysia car overall. It looks more like a, you know, Japanese car. This car even comes with a spoiler over here. The car itself came with a 13-inch alloy wheel, which actually looks pretty neat and nice. Kind of looks like a Honda wheel though. And the most interesting thing is that they actually put the windshield water spray over here instead of on the hood to maintain the aesthetics of the car. Good thinking, man.
Even though this is a small car, never missed out, the cargo space is actually pretty big. You know what I'm talking about? I can actually go inside, you can actually hide a full person in here, full grown person. I can, you know, a little bit of acrobating here and there, I can fit myself in here easily. And of course, never forget that these seats do fold down for longer cargos if you are into, you know, buying IKEA tables and stuff. Car, of course, the car comes standard with keyless entry. And it even comes with keyless engine start over here. Okay, it's even more interesting when I'm in the car. As you can see, I am over 6 foot, about 185 cm, and I have like whole tons of headroom over here. A surprise for a small car. It's very surprising for a small car. And then in terms of the interior, it looks good. You know, it looks like a car. It looks like what a car should look like in 2018. Such as the piano black console, chrome accent over the air vents, fake aluminum finish here and there for a little bit of a styling. And they even have chrome accents over here, which is neat. Modern looking steering wheel, modern looking tachometer, and even a front parking sensor. Yes, this car has front parking sensor, no joking. And do you know what? This car even have automatic folding mirror, which is epic. The seats is fabric. This is what you expect from a very cheap car manufacturer. And it actually feels and looks pretty decent. At least the seat is black color instead of a grayish or silver or beige, which kind of makes the car looks really out of date, but this is black, thank God. Whereas the glove box is a bit in the smaller side though. Don't expect to fit anything big in there. And there is a mini glove box over here. I'm not sure what kind of stuff you can put in there. Maybe some sort of a, maybe chain or something, changes or something. So pretty much that glove box is kind of useless. We got a cup holder over here, which is holding my camera bag. We got another cup holder over there, more compartment over here, two more cup holders over here, which is basically useless because it's a little bit too small. More compartment here to store your maybe cards and stuff. Do you know what? Even though that this is the cheapest car in Malaysia that money can buy, this thing actually comes with Bluetooth. Yes, this car comes with Bluetooth and not the Mitsubishi Mirage, which is probably the worst new car that you can buy without a Bluetooth. At least this thing has Bluetooth. Build quality wise, never expect anything else. It is cheap plastic, basically all over the place, but you don't expect to have high quality materials from a very, very, very cheap price. This car comes with one and two airbags, so you are safe, I guess.
The rear space, I would say, is kind of decent. I'm about 6 foot tall and 185 cm, and there is actually, I can fit 2 feet on top of my head before I actually touches the roof. The chair is a little bit at the uncomfortable side, but this is what you expect from a very cheap car, but at least the handle is a little solid, and you have cheap plastic here and there.
The seat belt is in a very odd position for the middle dude over here. It's dangling right in the middle of the car, and we got seat belt over here and the other side as well. In terms of engine capacity, this thing comes with only 1 liter dual VVT-i. So if you want like huge powers and stuff, I don't think this car can satisfy you. But if you really want a car that can bring you from destination A to destination B in one piece, and you still want to have a little bit of a modernized feature, I think this is the car for you.
So let us give this car a little test drive and see what this thing can do. All right, here we go. The steering is at the stiffer side though, which is not my preference, because this is not even a sports car, so you do not need stiff steering like this. Or maybe I just got used to driving sports cars, not these kind of cars. Is that the noisy side? Road noise is there. Let's try on the acceleration a little bit. Oh my god, this car have no acceleration at all. No way, this car is dead. In terms of acceleration, this car is no go. Oh my god, what about the cornering? I don't think this car is even... Whoa. No man, this car is not good for rough drivers like me, man. I just got used to drive a little bit faster. If you want to compare this to my sports cars and stuff, this is definitely not the car for you. But in terms of driving from destination A to destination B, this car is more than comfortable to do that. Okay, you can have Bluetooth, you can have aux, you can even, you know, answer your phone call, which is the best part. But overall, I would say this is a decent car for beginners in Malaysia. So. And it is cheap, that's the thing. Reliability wise, doesn't seem to be a problem, so yeah. So if you insist to own a car and you don't have that money and you still want a car that can bring you from destination A to destination B in one piece and still want it to stay very comfortable in some degree though, I think this is a decent car. But if you are talking about great handling, great acceleration, you know, great road comfort, this is definitely not the car that I would recommend. But the only good thing of this car is fuel consumption, because it consumes very, very less fuel, which is the good thing. At least the interior design of the car doesn't make you feel like you are in a stone age.
Alright, that is off today. Guys, thank you for watching. Like this video if you like it, dislike this video if you do not like it, subscribe if you haven't already, and of course I'm gonna see you in the next video. Adios and have a nice beautiful day.